So much for those kind words of introduction. And basically, Dr. Yakaya, teacher educator by profession, and would like to empower all the teachers, and a researcher ever since. Not that because today I'm a teacher educator, I'm doing research, I'm interested in research, but as a teacher, when I worked as a government school teacher in 1996, I took my first project to find out the reasons for scheduled caste girls lagging behind in education in that particular mandal where I was working. All right. And ever since, it's to my credit, so far I've guided 7 candidates as a supervisor and more than 100 as a supporter for their education. And I've also conducted state level and national level research projects sponsored by ICSSR, UGC, Sarvashiksha Abhiyan and other state and national level organizations. So with these brief introductory words, I would like to move on to the topic. That's how to select the topic for dissertation. All right. Hope you are able to see my screen now. Somebody confirm me.
Yes.
Great. Yes,
and audio video is clear.
Yes,
that's
sir.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir. That's great. A few things which I would like to make it clear for the current presentation is, as in the information brochure we have given, we are intended to give you a brief outline, but the main target is for you. If some of you are already identified and working on your research to refine your topic, or some of you are going to choose as a part of your MEd, MA degree or other any course degree to find out a topic, or you have one, not exactly a student, but I also find some of my friends, colleagues, and here, if you have a upcoming project, like either research project or a research paper publication in your mind to identify a topic for that. So wherever possible, I'll be inviting you. And so I request you active participation. And if language, don't worry, that's never a constraint. If so, you can understand I'm very poor at Hindi, and if some of you poor at English, it's not an issue. But still, I can understand and your question, and I can answer. And in between, we have our teacher education SS facilitator coordinators. So required, they also will be coordinating and helping us to mutually understand. All right. With these brief words, let me go ahead. Why dissertation, basically? The first thing comes to our mind is a degree program requirement, mostly at MEd level, because then when I named it as a dissertation or a question for lecture on demand has come, we thought many MEd students or MA education students who have a dissertation as a part of their fourth semester, normally the last semester, as a partial fulfillment of their degree course, they are asking. And this particular session is also mainly meant for them, but not excluding anybody interested research at any level. All right. So therefore, basically, it's at PG level, and of course, after that, MPhil, PhD level, it's a degree program requirement. But to begin with, either MA education or MEd Master of Education programs, it's a preparation for future research work. If I recollect my own experience, as far as education field, that is the teacher education is concerned, basically I am a mass graduate, BSc, MPC. And the first time when I joined B.Ed, I just recollect three things all through these last 20, 25 years, three important things which either sparkled, bothered, or tensed me at times. It's first time looking at those philosophy, psychology, and other subject-based general teacher education based subjects. When I just first joined B.Ed, I was wondering what all these subjects are about. And then during my M.Ed course, I was wondering about what is this dissertation work. If I recollect, or I'm sure it's experience with some of you also, if any student of master's degree has worked hard enough, or wondered, or stressed, tensed, consulted, searched a lot, it is mostly is with regard to the dissertation work. even rest of the practical teachings and project work, subject-based engagements might have done like a walkthrough, but definitely this is one area where I have struggled, consulted, and tried and tested a lot. All right.
Excuse me, sir.
Yes, please.
We are unable to see your presentation.
Okay, just a minute. I'll share. Great. Thanks for asking for that. Feel free as and when. That's okay. Right away, I'll share it again.
Okay, sir. Thank you.
You'll be able to see that. The screen is still visible to others. Stop screen sharing. Okay. And let me reshare.
Sir, excuse me. Actually, it was, you can see.
Okay.
Now okay, sir. Now okay.
All right. I'm come back. If somebody was not able to see now also, please check at your end. Yes, now it is fine. And the second thing is, suppose if you are seeing my picture, see that there is one more Yakaya presentation, and there you will be able to see. I hope you are able to see why dissertation. This is what the slide I'm talking about. We have already discussed about this first bullet point, degree program requirement, because MA education, MAD education. Second, preparation for future research work. So this I'm talking about my own experience. As a B.Ed. student, I wondered about philosophical, sociological, psychological, and school administration, the theoretical part, apart from math and physical sciences, because which I have studied up to graduation, there was not a much difficulty in understanding or the need and importance of them, but I wondered about those theory papers. As a master's student in my M.Ed. program, I was wondered much about this dissertation. And I am sure most of you also have had this experience as far as research work is concerned. And the third reason could be is interested in research. Initially it is so, but after we present our dissertation, yeah, there we understood. All through the 6 months or 9 months we were working for the dissertation work, we felt it like a burden, like almost something which is impossible kept at a master's level. They don't want us to complete the master's degree and so on. So kind of talks. But later on, yes, we just got the taste of what the research is. And then advance or direct your career. For some of you in future, it may be happening. It's like for up to graduation or below that, it is main responsibility of a teacher is teaching. But graduation, university level, post-graduation, and other research institutions, if you were to work tomorrow, your major work is to carry on research, and the second, of course, in addition, you may have some teaching and education responsibilities. So therefore, at times, it helps for advance or direct your career. And then personal satisfaction and accomplishment, it also could be. We see the senior professors also carrying on research these days. Even after retirement, people are continuing their research endeavors. Now, at that stage, they have no expectation of either a promotion or any other benefits, then but what it is your personal satisfaction and accomplishment. So first I invite you all, if you are here, yeah, because there is a program requirement, I have to do this dissertation. Or if you are at here or anywhere here, your research or preparation for future work, these three most welcome. But otherwise, the ultimate stage where you are going to reach is here, where you will have a personal satisfaction and accomplishment when you do a piece of research to your satisfaction, or when you guide somebody else, either it could be your friend, it could be your co-scholar, it could be your student in future, and you will have this, what is called the personal satisfaction and accomplishment. Now, as on date, wherever you are here on this 5 points area, that's okay. Because this is a research journey where you begin, because it is a program requirement and it is preparation for future research work, and you gradually develop interest and then you advance as part of your career or your interest. And finally, stage where the research work will give you the personal satisfaction and accomplishment. Don't know, sir, God knows about personal satisfaction and accomplishment, but I am much worried or wondered if you are a master's student. That's okay. It's a perfect place to begin with. Don't worry. We come from that particular stage, and now we are here to support you and guide you. Thanks to this online media that's available these days, and at least you can ask a question, anybody, everybody across the globe, including India particularly, and this particular platform which has come forward to help you and to support you. So thus, at least on this note, I would like to say you have an additional source where you can consult. All right. So in this regard, I think those of you who have been following for some time are aware. If you miss the live, some of your friends, or you want to revisit these lectures, and our teacher education SS coordinators are uploading the same also on your YouTube. So you can visit there. You can type your comments or queries there, or directly you can send under the question and demand category or any other category, or in continuation of this lecture and demand category. And we assure you from this platform that we will address your questions. If required, as you go through your process, a series of lectures, maybe a 3 or 4 at regular intervals, once at least a month, we can have, starting from sample selection. That is one area apart from the topic selection you will be requiring. Tool selection, and then presentation of your tool, and finally facing the Viva Voice. Okay. All right, let's move on. Then why topic selection is so important? And if you look at any standard book on research methodology, steps of research, the first and foremost step, what do you find it is? The choosing the topic, or defining the problem, finding the research problem with different headings, but ultimately it talks about it because it sets tone for your research. Now, once you identify the topic, until that time you will be jumping from one topic to another topic, one area to another area, one interest to another interest. But once you choose your topic, what happens is it sets tone for your research. So you are going to focus on that particular topic, that particular area. Otherwise, we have this popular saying, well begin is half done. So selection of the topic from that perspective point of view, it is almost a half successful work beginning. All right. Then it states the scope and focus of thoughts. Once you identify your topic, now what happens? What is the scope of your research work for the current research piece of work? What are the areas you need to focus, you need to concentrate, you need to search, browse through, think upon, ponder upon, collect relevant information, tools, discuss with the people, and all that will be possible. It's like crossing the first hurdle of your research life cycle. It's preparation for your future work. Right, so therefore the selection of the topic is important. All right, now what is a perfect dissertation topic? The 3 points here, it said yes, why dissertation work and why the selection of the topic, and at least you give us this third piece of information that will be good enough for this evening. What is that? Anyway, in your schedule also you have promised one topic of our research we are going to identify. So that's where we come, that it is, what is a perfect dissertation topic? Right, any guesses, any ideas on that? Anybody would you like to respond? Do you have something like, already I have identified one, I want to know whether it is a perfect topic for my research or not? Or if you have an idea about what a perfect dissertation topic is?
I think the top best topic for dissertation is that when the topic we complete within time.
Okay,
and topic data is easily available.
Great, got the point. Two important things she has mentioned. I'm sorry, I could not see your name because I am on a presentation mode. Okay, so the thing is, the one which you can complete in time. And if you want to complete your dissertation in time, what is required data should be available. Possibility of getting data. Okay, the two important aspects as far as at least a perfect dissertation topic was mentioned. Any other ideas?
Sir, it should meet the desired solution to the problem. Likewise, we are having the online teaching methodologies. Okay. So we should come up with certain things which can be the solution of the current issuing problem of society, of country, or of...
All right, thank you. I got the point. What you are saying is it should suggest or come out with some solution to the problem on which you have conducted the research. At the end of the research, again, you pose a question how this can be solved, and that piece of research is not really a good or a perfect kind of work. But the question, one important thing I want to see, whose problem? Nation problem, state problem, system problem, education problem, or literally to state the problem stated in the topic. At the end of that piece of research, the problem stated in the topic has to be addressed, solved, or resolved. All right, good idea. Yes. Now, some of you have some more ideas right away. You may not be able to tell us. Just type in the text chat box. After a few slides, I will visit the chat box. We will discuss on them also. For all of others, I invite you. I'm sure you must be having one pen and paper. Just write them. By the end of this particular topic today, this session, you are going to come out with one topic for yourself. Or if you have already you have a topic, you are going to verify it. Yes, is it going to be a perfect dissertation topic? Now, before we move forward, let us explore the myths and facts about perfect dissertation topic. Mostly when we ask which is a perfect dissertation topic, I remember in my experience, most of the students saying that the sir, topic given by you or topic given by my research supervisor. Because most of the cases, particularly the postgraduate students, MA or MEd of education students, tend to think that why all this go and ask the supervisor, because he's experienced or he's the one who will be guiding you through. So whatever he or she gives is a perfect dissertation topic. This is under myth number one. The fact is no. The fact is the topic given by your research supervisor or research guide will not be a perfect dissertation topic always. Need not necessarily is a perfect. That could be a perfect topic for if your research supervisor or the guide to take up the research. Now this time, who is taking the research work? Is your supervisor or yourself? It's yourself. It's for you, it's for me. It's for the candidate who choose the topic. So therefore, always remember that it should come from the candidate, the researcher, the postgraduate student, not the guide or supervisor. Does it mean guide or supervisor should not be consulted? No. Definitely is an important person. He's a significant person. He has to be consulted. His opinions have to be given due importance in finalizing your topic. I have no doubt with all these things. But topic should not be given by the research supervisor, and a candidate should not expect to get the topic, the topic to be given by the research supervisor. This is the myth and the fact there lies it is. The second one, those available on internet. These days for anything you Google it, right? Even the best notepad seller near your home, you will type in, click in the Google and you will get it. My dear friends and colleagues, especially let me emphasize on this. This has become a trend. Even some of the teachers suggesting, some of the students and friends and colleagues, peer group suggesting and going by it. Please note that I'm not against your consulting the Google or other online resources, but that doesn't give you a perfect dissertation topic. It will give you probable topics. It will suggest you ongoing topics. it will suggest you the most research topics or otherwise a trending topic. After a while, if you revisit that site, the topic may not be there. Or the review on that particular topic or the areas written will be a totally different. I mean to say, you do consult, but don't think that something is given on internet, readily available topic is a perfect topic. Before you finalize your topic, you're consulting, you're visiting, you're searching online sources is perfectly okay. But because something is given in some source, including anybody, even if it is me, Dr. Yakaya gives, or the teacher education SS platform gives, or the online Quora, Google, or any other e-thesis websites gives, they are only a suggestive. All right? Otherwise, if I have to give you one comparison to understand, if you just go by this, those available on internet are the perfect dissertation topics, is something you believe that matrimony.com, whatever they suggest, is a perfect partner for you. I'm not saying by chance for somebody, they might have got, or only for advertisement, they might have given on the site. But it's not that what your matrimony.com suggests you go. Definitely you take information, you verify many of the things, you check so many things, so much so process. The same thing I'm talking about this. Third, those done by your seniors. This is another practice, or unfortunately became a kind of trend. Whenever the topic is to be chosen, first you go to your library, your college library, university library, the institution library, and see the dissertation submitted by your seniors 2 years, 3 years, 5 years back the years, and look at some topics that you are interested in, and then go with one topic. And because he took 50 sample, I will take 100 sample. He took one district and I'll take the other district, and some variables change. This what happens is just you are doing a copywriting work in research rather than doing any research work. And the fact about such practice, let me tell you, is neither you will be happy end of the research, nor your supervisor, nor the person whose work you have carried out. Because after you carry out, if you see your report, I don't know what happens to that person. Is this the purpose of my submitting a dissertation report is to the library copy? He may regret. I'm not against consulting the previous dissertations. Definitely it is an integral part of identification of topic. We are going to see in a short while. But just simply copy paste the topic, change some variables, doesn't make a good topic live about a perfect dissertation topic. Right? Any other myths or the practices that in your practice that comes to your mind, whether somebody suggested or somewhere you have heard, you have come across, I invite you to bring in your own experience here in this context. Yes, please. Anybody, those of the seniors that are present, colleagues, dear friends, if you'd like to share any of on those lines, these lines are something related to this, you're most welcome.
Yes, one myth is that it must supported by previous research, and that has unexplored also, sir, that that is not explored yet, and it must supported. If you no supported past research, that will be useless research.
Great. Vijay Sagarji, thank you for bringing in that. Another important, there is a fact and there is a myth. This is an interesting point. What Vijay Sagarji has brought is unexplored. I just would like to add this here. Yes. Able to see this unexplored? Yes. So this unexplored is definitely another important point or aspect as far as research topic to be, that's a perfect or at least a good and a workable. But if you type any word these days, in Google or in any of the search engines, definitely you will find somebody have done some work on this. All right. So yes, the myth is nobody has done on this topic. I want to do on such a topic. You don't have a topic. But the fact there is, even the best research for last 6 decades, 7 decades topic also will have some unexplored dimension of it. Yes. In technical terms, we call it as a research gap. Much of the research have happened, but there is a gap. There is unexplored area. Identify that and definitely you are going to get a good topic. That's a great point to add on. And if anybody else would like to, one more person would like to share, I will be happy to take that and before I move forward. Otherwise, I encourage you, as usual, like in the write in the chat also, as well as just note down in your paper.
Most interested. The area which we are interested more.
Okay. The area in which you are more interested. A fact about it and a myth. It's a fact. Definitely, ultimately, the area in which you are interested is the probable area, is a potential area, is the most important area to explore for the topic. Undoubtedly, candidates interest. Candidates interest. Yeah, good. I like. But the myth about this is, at times, if you are interested in such a topic which is too large scope, which is practically not possible. Let me share you my own experience in this regard. In the year 1998, when I qualified my JRF and approached my professor, and I said to my professor, I want to do research on disabled children, how to educate them on par with other children. In 1998, visually challenged, hearing challenged, locomotor, mentally challenged, all to be educated in regular, normal class with all other children. Almost that was a practical impossible, because professor with his own experience, he said, it's a good idea, your interest I respect, but practicability is a limitation. So therefore, now you know certain categories of differently abled children or disabled. In those days, they were called like that. Divyangajan, as you know, now the government of India has coined the number. Otherwise, physically challenged, mentally challenged, a variety of words are being used these days. Now you look at different categories and you find out one category with whose education you want to do research. Then I said, no, sir, that's very limited one category. I want to do all other categories. Then the professor said, your interest is good, I appreciate it, but practicality, possibility also you have to see. So go search some of the work done on these different categories of children and then get back to me with one of your most interesting topic at this moment to carry on your
Sir, I think relevant topic is also a major component.
Yeah, relevance of the topic, applicability, relevance. Yes, good. Many relevant things have come. So let me move forward to the next slide. Here you could see what is a perfect dissertation topic. So we have seen, not just given by the research supervisor, of course, based on his advice or his suggestion or his remarks, you can go refine and progress. Not just the one readily available on internet, you also explore it, its possibilities, its relevance, practicality, scope, and those done by your seniors. Definitely you can see that as a model topics are the broad areas or the scope or the methodology they followed and the kind of presentation they have used for preparing their dissertation, but not in toto. And the unexplored areas, identifying the research gap and the candidate's interest ultimately. All right. So now, some more facts about the perfect dissertation. All right, dissertation topic. Could you see here that there are no perfect husbands and no perfect wives? But if you will keep believing in each other, there will be a plenty of perfect moments in married life. So this is what come to my mind when I was just thinking yesterday about this much. One Swami by name Subodhananda, sometime back I was attending one of his seminar, and he said one in the regarding of a perfect match. So one person searched.
Excuse me, sir.
Yeah.
Perfection.
Yeah, somebody could hear that. Let me know. Is there any issue with the presentation? Able to see here?
Yes, yes, Himanshu Kumar, sir, please stop presenting. Sir has started presenting and.
Okay, somebody else is presenting. Please, you stop presenting. Anybody else? Sharing.
Please stop presenting, Himanshu, sir.
Yeah, just.
Then, shall we go ahead?
Sorry. Yeah, yeah, sir.
All right.
Yes.
So therefore, it seems
criteria for perfection.
Yeah. What is the perfect dissertation topic, and what are the facts about it? We are trying to explore that in that context. It seems one student wanted to do a research on a perfect topic, approached the professor. Professor advised whatever he has to say, go explore and find out, and all these what we just discussed. Like you see, you consult the seniors' topics and the internet and the other possible sources. And this person has gone and he did not come back 1 year, 2 years. And the third year, professor have called on back. What happened? It has been a long time.
Sir, your presentation is not visual.
Okay. Let me check what's happening. Anybody else?
Someone else has presented, but yeah. Now he is stopped.
Sir, now sir, it's still it not visible.
Sir, आपको एक बार फिर से present करना होगा क्योंकि किसी ने बीच में present किया था ना तो फिर आपको.
Is that okay now?
Yeah.
No.
No.
Shall I reshare?
Yes. Yes, sir. Now
able to see these facts, right? Okay. So after 3 years, and this researcher goes to the professor and says, "Professor, now I have come with a perfect dissertation topic, and I would like to start." Then the professor said, you are not a perfect candidate to do that research. What happened? Because if you took 3 years to find out a perfect topic, I'm afraid, when are you going to complete your dissertation? So therefore, yes, you need to search for a workable, a practicable, a manageable, a meaningful, and a relevant topic rather than a perfect dissertation. So therefore, the fact is there is no perfect topic. To say that, fact is there is no perfect topic. And some of you may be wondering.
Sir,
yeah.
Sir, data जो मतलब कि topic के according मिलता है sir.
Hmm.
उसको हम उसको किस अनुसार से वे करेंगे जो थोड़ा सा मतलब research का fact improvement करें.
You're talking about analysis of the available data for the research. उसके बारे में पूछ रहे हैं आप जो information मिल गया data कैसे analyze करना उसके लिए finding के लिए. हाँ. So we will be discussing that in maybe future some other topic. But for now, because you have brought in what I want to address and answer is, अब जो देखिए the data is quantitative or qualitative. It is quantitative, then some statistical suitable. Statistical methods will be applied and data will be analyzed. Or if it is qualitative in nature, the qualitative description will be written and the further details of it may be given in some other. At the moment, we will concentrate on the identification of the topic. That's the scope for the today's lecture. In future, we can take on these things also. All right. So therefore, the point in this context, we are talking, there is no perfect topic. Then what do you mean, sir? I did my PhD and I got my doctorate. I did a major research on the topic. I have guided so many students with good, perfect dissertation topic. Good topics, I agree. Relevant topics, I agree. Practicable topics, yes. Manageable topics, yes. Perfect, definitely. Down your own conscious, my own heart, when I look, didn't I felt, hey, I would have done this way, I would have done that also, I would have included this also. So perfection doesn't come in the research in one go. We do the research towards an ultimate goal called perfect. So therefore, what to expect for now? Yes, don't worry.
Sorry,
when I say there is no perfect topic, but yes, let me also put it, the other important fact related to this is, but there are infinite researchable topic. Yes, please.
सर पीपीटी दो मतलब दूसरे भी उससे प्रेजेंट कर रहे हैं, तो जिसको नहीं दिख रहा है वो सर का दूसरा वाला आईडी पिन कर ले तो दिखने लगेगा। बहुत लोग मैसेज कर रहे हैं कि उनको पीपीटी नहीं दिख रहा है, तो आप उसको पिन कर लीजिए जाकर, फिर सभी को दिखने लगेगा। ओके सर, थैंक यू।
इज दैट फाइन, लेट्स गो अहेड।
यस सर प्लीज।
या ऑलराइट, सो the two important facts related to your perfect dissertation topic, one is there is no perfect topic, but don't get disheartened, nothing to worry about that, because there are infinite researchable topics, practicable topics, relevant topics, manageable topics, useful topics, productive topics, problem solving topics, innovative topics, creative topics, topics that gives you the satisfaction of the research. So therefore, nothing to worry, but you need to take care of a few of these. What are those five important steps to be considered for topic selection? In today's presentation, we are going to concentrate on these five steps, by the end of which you will be in a position to identify or refine or finalize one topic for your research endeavor. Those five steps includes, number one, your interest. As just now, while discussing about the myths and facts, some of our friends have brought in, and otherwise the most important is your interest. Then followed by finding a research gap. I was just sharing this point. And then third, choose something original. Yes, another one of our friend have brought in this. Originality, newness, unexplored areas. And then at the same time, we also have discussed limit the scope. That is important. You just can't do all at one go, especially for a MA or MA dissertation. The scope is one of the most important thing to limit, practically manageable in view of the time and the resources available. And finally, ask for advice. Because research is not one man show. One person do carry on the research, but definitely it is a collaborative. It is a team effort. It is a group coordination, which consists of your research supervisor, your co-scholars, your other friends and experts, and of course, your sample also will be a part of it. All right. So now let's explore these five points one by one. Your interest. Now the first question to choose, or if you have identified some topic, you have to ask yourself is that, what topic am I interested in? Am I interested in this topic which I propose to carry on my research work? Sir, what if topic is practicable, manageable, and if I don't have interest, but I do, I submit and I'll get the degree, what is the big deal? There is no big deal, but there is no gain for you as a researcher. It's just for sake of degree. That's it happens. You're not going to put neither your head nor your heart in that. And let me tell you particularly as far as the dissertation at master's level is concerned, the most beneficiary is the researcher. Really, it's not going to influence your field. Really, it is not going to solve the problem of some group of people or individual person or institutions. What all you get is training in the process of carrying research. So therefore, if your interest is not there, if you are not benefited, and who else? The Xerox paper and the binding company might have got benefited of your dissertation, but of no use. So therefore, definitely it must be of the interest. When we have discussed about the myths and facts about the perfect topic. Also, we said it's not your guide or supervisor's interest alone. Of course, the matching of supervisor interest is an additional point, is a bonus, is a fetching point, is an advantageous point. But whether even if your supervisor is not really interested, much interested on the topic, but if you are interested, it's worth of doing it. But how? You convince, you discuss, you talk to your supervisor, express why and what reason you want to do that, how you are interested, what is your research interest, not personal interest, by the way, what is your research interest in carrying out a research on that topic, and then you can go ahead. So to do that, what you need to do, brainstorm some research topics. Just think, just write down, just whatever comes to your mind. In the very first go, you don't get the topic. Please note down that. Some keyword comes to your mind. Some broad area comes to your mind. Some similar topic comes to your mind. Some question kind of thing. Is ICT going to address the challenges of the current season of COVID educational transaction? This is not a researchable topic in the same format, but definitely just write down that as a topic initially. Like this, whatever the topic you get to your mind, the brainstorm, free flow thought, silly, practicable, impracticable, all that we will put on later. Initially, you put so many conditions, things will not move. Anything that just comes to your mind out of your interest, out of your choice, out of your familiarity, out of your command over the subject, out of your previous experience, out of your observation, out of the problems and challenges you have faced or you have seen people facing in the field, yes, jot down, just jot down, just jot down. The beautiful thing, what I say is, before you finalize your topic, at least write down 10 relevant topics, without which you will be missing some important. Later you will realize that I could have done this. Right. So thereby what happens? Identify broad areas of your, when you write 10 topics, out of 10 topics, 4 to 6 normally, in my experience, out of 10, if you write, 4 to 6 will have related, somewhat related to a broad field. Now that indicates, oh, you are interested in this area. If I write 10 topics, definitely 4 to 6 topics will be something related to inclusive education, or will be definitely something related to ICT integration, depending on my broad field I wanted to carry on the research. Then that gives you to identify your broad areas of interest. Then check. Then read some general background on what is happening with the ICT integration. What is happening in the inclusive education? What is happening? What are the recent trends in the guidance and counseling? Suppose when I get these three or four broad areas, I will do some general background information and then come out with a project title and then begin. Is my project doable? Manageability, practicability. Because these days of COVID season, it is, we have some challenges in physically attending the classes. So suppose some idea comes to my mind, how to carry on education without visiting your educational institution. Okay, good. But then what about the practically doable this thing? In the air it is. So I have to find out what is the alternative. What is the mode I would like to propose or go ahead as an alternative means to the physical classes, and then finding the research gap. At this stage, once I finalize the broader area and one or two topics, and then do some, read some dissertations, a thesis or abstracts that are available on that topic. So far I have done, particularly recent 5 to 10 years. Make a list of useful keywords. Choose a broad field, now finalize.
हेलो सर।
यस मैम। Okay, was that addressed? Can we go ahead? Second step, after identification of the topic, background theoretical information, first chapter, then we will go for the second chapter, review of related literature. But don't think that, sir, of course.
Sir, please focus something on operational definition, sir.
All right. Okay. After a few more slides, I'll give you an opportunity. And you just can ask, I will specifically discuss about that. But otherwise, another 5-10 minutes, I will make my presentation. And then I'll discuss about operational definition and the relevant things. All right? Create an outline review. Review actually second chapter for your final dissertation. But at this stage, going through the review will give you the further clarity, practicality, refining, finalizing. So therefore, students are encouraged to carry out the review and identifying the research gaps before finalizing the topic, and which will help them in preparing their research proposal and also in the final topic. Then third, choose something original or different. So this is definitely always. This is one unique feature of a research work, which is different from your assignment, project work, or other work as such. Definitely the originality, some difference. Find an angle to ensure unique contribution to your field. And in my case, when I have come out after my professor have suggested, not all differently abled children, but you go with one particular group, then I just have come out with what is said LD, learning disabled or learning difficulties.
सर रिसर्च गैप क्या है सर थोड़ा बता दें
रिसर्च गैप इज सपोज इन दोस डेज व्हाट आई एम टॉकिंग 1998 लॉट ऑफ रिसर्च वाज डन ऑन फिजिकली चैलेंज्ड मेंटली चैलेंज्ड हियरिंग चैलेंज्ड बट एलडी लर्निंग डिसेबिलिटीज इज नॉट नोन इन दैट एरिया देयर इज अ गैप ब्रॉड फील्ड आई एम इंटरेस्टेड इज इन स्पेशल एजुकेशन लेट अस से इन दैट SEN, children with special educational needs. Now, when I go through the studies, a lot of studies are there on physically challenged, mentally challenged, hearing, locomotor, but LD, learning disabled or learning difficulties, was a gap. In those days, a topic as such area was a gap. Now, today, if you see LD, you have good number of studies, but in that, again, you will find a gap like, for example, how ICT can help the children with learning difficulties to provide inclusive education. Now you will find studies on LDs. You will find studies on ICT, integration, information and communication technology integration. Now what is the research gap? How ICT can enable to provide inclusive education for learning disabled children. Now if you see this is the gap. Here is the research required. You find out. Now frame your topic in this area, anything. Yes, all these criteria will be fulfilled. It will be relevant, it will be original, it will be practicable, it will be useful, and all this will come, right? Stay away from any area that's oversaturated. Suppose if I'm interested in studying IQ level and academic achievement of the children. Now almost you name any variable, any district or any state in country, you will find the number of studies on that. So therefore, I just can't go ahead with that, but that's oversaturated. Does it mean nowhere? No, no. You can again think of some originality in that. Instead of IQ, if I say EQ, emotional quotient, emotional intelligence and its influence on the children, classroom adjustment, Again, if you say emotional intelligence and achievement, last 10 years, there is a lot many studies. That is the research done area. Now, how do you identify the gap in that emotional intelligence and classroom adjustment of secondary school children? Oh, you see now studies, you don't find much. Studies on emotional intelligence are there. Studies on children adjustment, classroom adjustment of the children are there. But the gap you have found, so wherein you can carry on the research. This ensues your research leads to unique conclusions. And the fourth important thing, once you identify, limit the scope. Don't be too vague or too narrow. If I say only learning disabled, education of learning disabled is too vague. Okay, teaching alphabets to learning difficulties children of my class, that is too narrow. So therefore, the topic should not be too vague, too broad, or too very action research kind of thing for your classroom. A classroom teacher can do that. Still, classroom teacher as a part of action research can do that. But a master level dissertation topic or MPhil PhD level, you just can't limit yourself to your classroom or your only school, that limited things. Then another important thing, as some of our friends have brought in when we were discussing about myths and facts, check the availability of data and tools. Let us baad mein dekhenge aage bade to, so you will face the problem at later stage. So therefore, is data available? Availability is not necessarily ready-made. Can I procure the data? Sources are available. How can I procure? Tools are available or the methods are available? So these things one has to check at this stage. And then consider the resources and time available, particularly master's dissertation level. You 1% carrying on, and maximum you have 4 to 6 months of time, one semester. So therefore one has to keep this also in mind. Yeah, somebody was saying something relevant, this question, please go ahead. Otherwise, I'll be moving. All right. Define your topic as a question. At times, finally, is this topic is a practicable, useful, relevant? Whenever you get a doubt, just define your topic as a question. If anybody has a topic in your mind, you give me, we'll frame a question. Meanwhile, yeah.
Yes, sir.
Yes, please.
Misconception in primary science.
Misconception.
Science.
Primary science.
Primary level science.
Okay. Primary level science, teachers' misconceptions or the students' misconceptions, which you would like to study?
Yeah.
Student.
Students' misconceptions.
Students. Okay. Common, does my study going to identify common misconceptions of primary school students about science? If you pose this question and answer yes, then your topic is going to qualify a practicable, relevant, and useful. So therefore, to be in that point of angle, what you should state, a study to understand the common misconceptions of primary school students related to science. All right? Yes, that is the topic. And when you frame this as a research question kind of thing, you will be able to cross-check. So that is one way how you can cross-check your particular topic, right? And finally, the fifth step, ask for advice. Whom to ask? Ask your supervisor, expert, seniors, peer research. All these matters. Instead of later stage, you go and ask and they say, each gives their opinion, no, this is not practicable, this is not possible, I don't think this is possible, all sorts of things will come. If you have any of these people to consult, better you consult in advance. And normally, students follow this reverse order. First your peer groups, classmates, then seniors, then experts, here this teacher, this senior, that senior, and then finally supervisor. But I encourage and advice, first go to your supervisor after framing a brief. You talk to any of these, but go to your supervisor. Definitely it is important. And after supervisor gives their comments, when you come back and work again, you can consult all these people. But without supervisor at any of these stage, expert said, and your mind will fix on, because he is a very great authority in this area. He has given the topic. How come my supervisor says? No, definitely. Either your supervisor should have that clarity, or you should give that clarity to your supervisor. Ultimately, it is supervisor understanding or convinced is also important, along with your interest. Your interest and supervisor's agreement, of course. Your interest is the first, and the second point is the supervisor's convinced or expertise or his interest or his readiness to guide you. He may not be interested. When I was guiding, one of my students came and he said, "Sir, I'm not interested in special education area." I said, "It's okay, but what is your interest?" "My interest is in the juvenile children." "That's okay, fine, go ahead." And then later on, I have developed interest in that. That's fine. All right, then discuss with your supervisor why and how you choose to prefer the topic. Talk to potential supervisors or colleagues. If your system is supervisor not allowed, already not allotted, you have to choose one. Yeah, discuss with 2-3 supervisors, whoever is interested, whoever shows some interest in that area, you can go with them. Because they have considerable experience in refining dissertation topics and are there to help you at every stage of your journey. So people, all these other experts, seniors, peer group will come and go, but all through your research journey for that particular piece of work, two people are constantly traveling in this journey is yourself and your supervisor. So therefore, definitely supervisors, consent, and those things are. So then what are some of the sources?
Hello, excuse me. Topic?
Yes, please.
Excuse me, sir. Is it possible for you to revisit the topic, finding a research gap? I could not understand. Only for 1 minute, if possible.
All right, definitely. What I am talking about the research gap is, once you go through the previous study, you will find what has already done.
And what, sir, please show the slides if possible.
Okay.
Finding a research gap.
I was more explaining about that rather than this. This is this one. Otherwise, if you want, you just can take a screenshot and we will discuss in the question and answer session also.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
All right?
Okay.
All right. Okay. Yeah. Then what are the sources of potential topics? Your experience, your observation and educational practices, specific questions you are interested to answer, suggestions for further research. Before we go to this, first three you observe again, I have kept your experience, your observation, the questions in your mind. Ultimately, the source of potential topic comes from you. Then suggestion for further research. Any research, dissertation or thesis, at the end we'll have one session called suggestion for further research. If they routinely gave, not much, but thoughtfully have given, definitely this will give you. Then recent trends and issues, what's happening? Experiential learning, for example, inclusive education, NPE 2020, Right to Education Act. And definitely, they are the broad areas, readily available topics. Just to name a few of the topics from my side, areas of potential topic, teacher education, the pre-service, in-service, open and distance learning, MOOCs, online, that is ICT integration, inclusive education, NPE 2020, RTE 2009, NCF 2005, NCFT 2009, performance-based rewards for teachers. In our system, we don't have performance-based rewards. There are rewards for teachers, increments, rewards, recognition, but which is not performance-based. Now it is high time to think on those. Then guidance and counseling for learners, artificial intelligence, AI is going to be used in a big way, both in teaching learning process, assessment, student database management, communication with the parents, automation of teaching learning process, all that. So therefore, these are some of the potential areas. Now, if you have a topic in your mind, you have identified or would like to jot down, you can jot down, and at this stage, we can have our discussion about the topic.
So please show the previous slide.
Right. This one you want areas of potential topics?
Yeah, yes.
Okay, I'll just maximize. If you want, you can take a screenshot. Yes. Now the forum is open for discussion, questions, queries, clarifications. Otherwise, if you have a topic ready, please read out. We'll discuss on that, or just write down one for the online.
Sir, is it possible to share this slide, PPT presentation?
Yes, we will
be shared
later on. Sir, I can't see any question in the chat box. There is no question.
All right.
If you have participants, if you have any doubt, you can ask.
Yes. If you are the one already identified your topic, you want to discuss on that, or you propose a topic you want to discuss on that, most welcome.
Sir, I have a topic in my mind. It is related to AI, artificial intelligence, in teacher education. How can we implement it in education? And the second thing which you were talking about was the automation of teacher education.
Okay. Now, these are two broad aspects. At least you have made a mention. You are interested in the artificial intelligence relevance in education. Now, first, what I recommend you is use of AI in teaching, classroom teaching, or in assessment, or in planning teaching, or in identifying student learning needs. This is the first specificity you need to go. Okay, AI can be used in any of these areas. In one research, you can't cover all these aspects. Okay? Use of artificial intelligence in developing student assessment profile, probably, for example, a beginning, because that's one area where we can readily use. Our secondary school students and as you can complete the statement later on with the discussion of your supervisor and the person. All right.
Sir, a question hai mera, sir.
Yeah.
Digitization ka jo topic hai, वर्तमान समय में at a present situation में हम किस अनुसार से कर सकते हैं? जैसे कि अभी COVID pandemic है, तो उसके situation के according digitization किस प्रकार से करें तो better रहेगा sir?
All right. Apart from all those topics are the criteria we have discussed, for the current season, data collection, is it possible through online? Because at least for another few months, going to field and collecting data is going to be a limitation. So therefore, in addition to these historically known factors, in the current season, you need to add one more factor to verify is, can I collect the relevant data online? Online need not necessarily always only a Google form kind of questionnaire. Can I take online interviews? Can I observe this process online? Can I collect the relevant information online? This is an additional point, at least for coming another 6 to 8 months, one needs to keep in mind if you want to. Or if your dissertation is to be submitted next year, here, this year you are only proposing the topic, that's okay. You can go ahead.
Excuse me, sir.
Yes, please.
Sir, in my mind, I have a topic on NCF 2020, NCP.
Okay.
Okay, so in what all areas that could be covered? So I find that the awareness, is it possible among the teachers or... in what all areas we can cover that particular topic, if taking as a dissertation?
All right. Yes. Is it for MAD dissertation? Point one.
Yes, sir. For MAD dissertation.
Right, Ria. Second thing, you just repeat what you said. NCF.
Sir, National Curriculum Framework that was proposed in the last year was being put forward by the government.
Okay.
So there are many initiatives and very many methods to get intermediate with the teachers and students, and there were many possible ways in which students can stand within the curriculum.
Yes.
So is there any relevance if I take that topic, NCF 2020, as my dissertation topic?
Yeah, definitely it is a trendy, relevant, useful topic, undoubtedly. The only thing is you have to narrow down it. NCF in teaching led student assessment, and then again within that, what specific aspect you are going to focus, you need to finalize. But you can go ahead with that area. As the area is fine, topic you need to point down, pin down it.
Sir, I have a point in my mind.
Yes, okay. Go ahead.
I study a democratic atmosphere of senior secondary school. Study a democratic atmosphere of senior secondary school of Uttar Pradesh or any province.
All right.
Or this topic is relevant, sir, or not?
The topic will be relevant, no doubt, but you need to be very specific. What you said is not topic, is a broad area. Democratic atmosphere of in your secondary schools is a broad area. From there, democratic atmosphere from the point of what? Student freedom, student discipline, or the HM of the institution administrative style?
Yeah, participation of student, guardian and teachers in policy and planning of school, SMC, parent teacher meetings, and other procedure of school.
Yeah. From this second statement, I got one clarity. What I can suggest is the democratic practices of senior secondary schools of so-and-so districts in UP, hyphen, participation of parents in preparing curriculum for the class transaction. Now you are going to focus on one area. For MA dissertation, that much is enough. How and to what extent the parents are in a democratic manner given an opportunity to participate in curriculum preparation and transaction. All right?
Hello. Yeah, good evening, sir.
Yeah. Yes, good evening. Please go ahead, ma'am.
Sir, I want some ideas related to my topic. Please help me with some ideas.
Vidisha, go ahead. What is your broader area interest? Do you have any broader area or topic?
My topic is a study on occupational burnout and professional adjustment of government and private secondary school teachers.
Okay.
So please provide me some ideas with it, sir.
All right. So far, you have stated topic is fine, but only one limitation is, as such, you are finding out only what is the professional burnout. But then what? Give some suggestions how to cope up with that, or to come out with a strategy to reduce that burnout factors. Something should have relevance. Otherwise, what happens? Only status. This many percentage of private teachers have got the burnout. This percentage of government teachers have got burnout. Either the causes or the remedies you need to add to your topic, so that may not be the relevant to solve some problem. Just think from that point of view. Causes or remedies.
Hello, sir.
Yes, Ashish, go ahead.
Sir, my topic for dissertation is misconception. Misconception. Okay, sir. Okay. My topic for dissertation is a misconception in science learning, misconception in primary science, but I'm unable to find a research gap, sir. I have gone through at least 10 to 15 research papers, dissertation, previous topics, related literature, but still I am not able. Is due to my lack of reading ability or anything else, and how should I proceed further?
No, don't worry. Even if I have to find out a research gap, I have to spend significant time on it. Don't worry. But what I say is, for example, we'll teach some science concept about motion. Okay. And children will have a concept that the moon is moving, right?
Okay.
For that matter, children will have a concept of all moving things have a life. psychological point of view, right? Now, in the scientific fact, we are going to teach that. So therefore, see that does anybody, at what age children are going to blindly believe that because of the stories told by previous? And after what concept start in science, they are going to develop a logical reason. Like it's not like as in the stories they heard, the moon is moving. Rather, there are certain principles that related to the movement of Earth and the moon kind of thing. So you need to thoroughly read what are the related topics in the science content of primary school, what are the conceptions of the children, and then go to the studies, and then you will be able to identify the gap where the things are not covered.
Excuse me, sir. Good evening, sir. I have a doubt. Mainly, I have seen, like, while doing our internship program and during our school time also, many times only adults and girls were given counseling sessions about their age and their changing behavior patterns and their about their changes in maturity levels and all. Why doesn't the boys are given such a type of counseling on a regular pattern, sir, in the schools? Can I have this topic as my dissertation or my proposal research topic, sir?
Definitely, a need for ongoing guidance and counseling about this particular aspect among secondary school students. Yes, you can. Possibilities and challenges.
Sir, can you just repeat that thing, sir? Just I want to note it down. What you have said. Need for?
Sir, is that like Indumati is having this kind of a research, right? Hmm. In that way, is it possible to have qualitative analysis in that context? Does she has to go for palliative testing and all that, or is just a qualitative paper is insufficient for her research paper, for her dissertation?
All right, let her propose, and as she go through, depending on the kind of tools she get, and she can go ahead. Indumati, so a study to provide guidance for secondary school students on dash aspect, you have brought in some aspects of your interest or your identified things. Possibilities and challenges. Because it's not done means there are some challenges. Because there are challenges, we are not going to stop. We will explore the possibilities.
Okay, sir. Thank you, sir. Thanks for
sharing. Yes, ma'am. Yes, Revati.
So, for this, only survey analysis can be sufficient, sir? Because it is an ongoing process.
Yeah, it can be a survey.
It's
a beginning a survey. Later on, to develop the ways and means of providing ongoing, that can be an experimental. Initially, it's a survey, basic survey.
So at this point of MA dissertation, this is acceptable, right?
Yes.
Thank you so much, sir.
Yes. Yeah, I see Revati, your mic is on. Go ahead.
Okay, is there any questions? Can you hear me?
Is there any topic related to new education policy?
Just a minute, Revati is trying to say something. We'll try to take it, otherwise then I'll get back to you. Yes, Revati, go ahead. Okay, sorry Revati, there is a
disturbance from our side.
You just type in and the people from Teacher Educator SS will read it on your behalf. We will take it on. Yeah, meanwhile, now the second person, you please go ahead. Someone tried to ask something.
Sir, is there any dissertation topic on new education policy? Can we choose any topic?
There can be hundreds on NEP 2020, not one, two, but on which aspect, what is to be nailed down?
Regarding special education, sir.
Okay.
Special need children or any benefit in new education policy is there?
Yeah, there are several propositions. As far as inclusive concept is concerned, again, within that, again, gender, physically challenged, and so many groups also have given. Just visit that section first, identify one area on which you want to study, and then find out that there are many studies on special education, but see the gap. Inclusion, definitely, is an emerging area, and then you can identify. There can be a quite good number of topics proposed based on the NPE 2020.
Sir, any website through which we can get to know, because many of them have asked about it, wherein the section for the special education in the NPE which has come. Is there any website we can go through?
Not exactly. I don't recommend to visit a particular website where the topic can be finalized, but you can visit, for example, that matter, the Association of Indian Universities, the University News, you know, and that also gives the recently done topics. And otherwise, you have ERIC, Educational Research Information Center, and that will give you. And then again, NCERT website, recent trends and topics, research, what is going on, they also will enlist. And anyway, the ETS the website, but from no source, I say you take a topic. You take ideas for topic, broader areas for topic, similar.
No, for review, I'm asking, sir, for review. Because for review, with many of the students are finding difficulty. So that is why I asked you. Thank you.
As far as review is concerned, probably we may have another session. But for now, what I'll say is definitely visit ERIC, Educational Research and Information Center. As far as Indian reviews are concerned that are available, Association of Indian Universities, AIU, NCERT website, and the other related sources.
Sir, Devati ma'am has asked, what is the count of reviews we need to add for a research work?
Yeah, there is no fixed hard and fast rule. There should be 10, 20, 50, 100. For some study, getting 20, 30 is a big deal. For some other study, even there are hundreds of studies. But when there are hundreds, you don't review all the 100. When hardly you will find 10, 20, you need not necessarily include all that. Depending on your topics, variables, methodology, relevance of findings, you can choose what it is said is a comprehensive review, not a quantitative number based. But some idea, just to give an idea, is anywhere 10 to 30 for MEd level, you can do review. But note that though either you do 10 or 20 or 30 or 50, it should include definitely recent studies. Last 10 years, some studies from last 10 years must be there. At least one study from each of the keywords of your topic must be covered. So those are the some things to see that the comprehensive nature of review rather than the quantity or the fixed number.
Okay, there is another question from Revati ma'am. Can you give some thoughts on narrowing down the reviews specific to the topic? Though we search by keywords, there is a huge list of literary works.
Yeah. Now, first thing is definitely you go by the keywords. Second thing is combination of keywords. Inclusive education and ICT and teaching learning process. Second thing, even then also you may be getting good. That's a good sign. But what to do is go through the abstract. Is there a relevance of your objectives and their study objectives? At least one objective in common, considerable. At least one variable, which is a major consideration of your study, is a variable studied by them? Yes. At least one research method which you are using, they also have used, or at least one finding of their study has got some implication related to your study causes or suggestions or findings. Like that, it's not just only keyword relevance, either variables or methodology or tools or objectives or findings relevance has to be considered. The more related, the more preferable. Or at least any one of these are common for your study and their study, you can go ahead with that.
Okay. Next question is from Alina Mishra. Sir, please suggest some topic ideas we can do related to ICT in these pandemic days.
All right. Now coming to the ICT, much initiative have started. Now, what is the parents' opinion on that? what is the students' challenges? What are the challenges faced by secondary school students in attending online classes? Measures can be taken to help them to overcome those challenges. Then once the challenges come in the preliminary round, the second round you can focus on the remedial measures. Or while remedial measures not just limited to the children, parents and the school management, probably that can be a second study in that case. Like that you can go on.
Excuse me, sir.
Hello.
Excuse yeah, Rita, 1 minute. If Rita can come down, I could see she has just started, and after that, Rajita. Yeah, Rita Gupta, go ahead.
Okay. Sir, my question is that before finalizing the topic, I have some review, literature of review, to study the literature of review, but I can't get in this time how, when, what is the means or where we get the related studies to before finalize our topic.
All right, fine. Now, Rita Gupta, you're talking about a topic which is very recent in nature, therefore there are not many studies. When there are, let us say something like this, as somebody said, what are the challenges faced by the students in attending online classes? But online classes, challenges faced by students in attending regular classes, there could be some challenges which are common for online and offline, right? So therefore, first priority as most relevant, second priority to some extent relevant, third priority distantly relevant. This is one criteria which you can use to find out some studies. Second thing, if not this, the methodology you are using, the variables you are covering, students' opinion, parents' opinion, management, members' difficulties faced by. Even in your conventional system, there were difficulties faced by students' management. So like that you can have, if not directly, exactly related, you will have similar distant related studies. They also are considered as a relevant when topic is very recent in nature and not many most relevant studies are available. They can be reviewed.
Sir, my question is where, when in the college library is not open today. So, where we collect the related study?
Yeah, as just now I have mentioned, ERIC, Educational Research Information Center, that will give ETC, vidyavivardhani.com. And so many are there. If you just Google, type in also, review, give you your topic and abstracts related to this topic, studies related to this topic, dissertation related to this topic, research findings related to this topic, like that also will give you some hints from where you can go and you will get further reviews online. As of now, we mostly depend on online. All right, somebody was asking some time back and also just now I got that query, is operational definitions. See, there is a slight important thing one has to understand, difference between definition and operational definition. And now see, learning difficulties, I will get the definition, dictionary definition or our special education or inclusive education related books definition. Now when I am stating an operational definition, what is that operational definition? A typical learning difficulty definition will see, will you will find is a child facing difficulty in reading, writing, arithmetic, speech and language. That is dictionary or etymological definition. Now in my study, I'm not going to cover all this. Say for example, I'm studying the learning difficulties in reading area, dyslexia problems of the children in secondary school. Then operational definition I should write, learning difficulty is a definition. Operational definition, in the current study, children who are facing difficulties in reading as identified through the reading difficulty test used for the present study are known as dyslexia students. Otherwise, dyslexia is a broader definition, standard definition you have. Now, in my study, I'm not considering all those. Who I'm considering? A student who have difficulty in reading, which was identified through using my reading difficulty test. So when you state practically, which person, how is identified or classified in recognizable terms through your research is your operational definition. All right, or otherwise, if you have some variable in your mind for which you are looking for operational definition, let me know. Let's try to define from that point of view.
Sir, myself, Rajita, an MMed student. Sir?
Yes, Rajita, please go ahead.
Okay, my topic is, I have a topic actually, the problems related with, the problem related with the education of their students. Is it a relevant topic, or can I go forward with that?
That's an area of the topic, but which problem of the single parent related to their education?
Education
faced by the single mothers in providing education to their children at secondary level.
Okay, one more time, sir. Can you tell one more time, sir? Say
challenges faced by single mothers.
Okay. Single mothers.
In providing
education
for the children at secondary school level.
Oh, okay. Thank you, sir.
The sample and all that you can define later.
Okay, sir.
Define your topic.
Sir, one more doubt I have. How many samples we have to collect? Is it 550 we need, or more than it?
550?
Is it enough? Actually, every time we have confusion with
single mother. See, 550 single mothers to find out, I think you need to spend 2 years minimum.
Not 550, 50. 50.
Okay. 50 is good, but if you get 50 is good enough. Otherwise, anything 30, 40 is also is okay. Because you are specifically talking about single mothers, and that too somebody who have a child of secondary school age. And then definitely, so anything 30 to 50 is okay for that.
Okay, thank you very much, sir.
Because sample depends on the topic, your sample definition, the population of your sample. Even if you take one district, single mothers having secondary school children will not be 1,000. So therefore, in that case, it's okay. A limited sample acceptable. All right.
Okay, thank you.
Yes, ma'am.
Excuse me, sir. It's me, Ria.
Yes.
I just want to ask, nowadays trolls are getting very much importance in our daily life. So if I take educational trolls, so actually I plan to have a pre-test and post-test among higher secondary students with these educational trolls. But with this pandemic, I cannot do it. Is there any other alternative method I could do
would you like to just say what sort of troll, educational troll, you are looking to study? For example,
I'm an English student, so I am looking for grammar-based educational trolls, and I just want to know how much students are convenient, or how much they can inculcate what I'm trying to say through these trolls.
Okay.
So is there any alternative method that I can use here?
Can you think of online which you can transact that and online, collect the data, pre-test, post-test, both online?
Both online, pre-test, okay. I'm trying
post-test, all the three online only.
Online only, okay, okay.
Yeah. You can go ahead if you can manage that.
Okay.
Yeah.
Sir, does it affect my relevance of the topic? I mean, accuracy? Will be there any problem with that?
No. See, always objectivity is, we will try to be objective from our point of view. Respondent point of view, we request them, we explain them, we try to ensure they also be objective, but there are limitations. That's okay. That is one of the limitations of the study itself, not yours or mine. Okay.
Okay, sir. Thank you. Thank you very much.
Yes. All right. I could see many questions in the chat box also, but because already we have crossed 7:30, it's 7:35, yes. And the sample and the methodology and those things we will be taking in the upcoming future, these things. But otherwise, anyway, it's okay. You can type in and I don't know.
So can we have a Sunday or every fortnight, yeah, this kind of session? That's because what, we have many kinds of...
Yeah, in the beginning, that's what I was suggesting. At least one session in a month, ongoing we can have, so that those all you are doing your research work or dissertation work as it goes on various aspects. We started with the topic, then one session on sample, another session on tools, another session on the presentation of research we may have. That is one request, I think, our teacher education SS coordinator and other team members are noting down, and we will do. At the moment, what I'm suggesting is questions you can send. I think the whatever you send in this chat will go off. They will not be there. Later on, you can raise the questions on demand or otherwise queries, and our people will take on and they will be communicating. And as far as possible, we will send you through our WhatsApp and Facebook group, or in the upcoming sessions, we will take up some more questions.
Sir, it is not good, but I'm asking, how can we approach you apart from this Telegram group or WhatsApp group if we have any queries? So how can we approach you, sir?
No, at the moment, I prefer and I'm committed to address through this channel. Otherwise, you see, if I liberally say and tomorrow I can't deliver, it will be a dishonor on my part. So therefore, to the best possible through this platform, I can address your queries, and based on that further requirement at that stage, I will tell on individual basis who requires, I may give my contact later.
Okay, sir. Thank you, sir.
Yes.
Okay. Now I think we are done with our question answer session. Thank you so much, sir, for this wonderful session, and this was very much interactive. Now I would like to invite, sir, I think you have summarized your topic. So I am directly inviting our chief coordinator.
Yeah, please go ahead. But before, just give me 2 minutes.
Okay, sir. Okay, sir.
Before we close, I would like to share is.
Okay, sir. Please summarize your.
Yeah, this topic. One. I hope you could see this. Are you able to see my screen now?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
So this is one thing which we very familiar for us, smart goal setting. The same I have applied here for your topic. After you select, going through these 5 steps which I have told, check yourself this SMART. Specific, is it specific? Is it measurable? Tools are available? Achievable, can I complete it within the given time and the purpose? Is it relevant today for the field, for me, per system? Can I complete in the time-bound framework? Check if you get at least 1 tick mark to each of these, yes, your topic is fine. As a recap, we have seen the purpose of research in one of the slides. It could be the requirement, it could be interest, it could be your future. And then the sources, we also have seen particularly your interest and your own experience and observation, then followed by suggestions from various sources and the recent trends. And then finally, I have also given some suggested areas which you have noted, and you have, I hope, come out with the topic. Otherwise, based on these 5 steps, go through, come out with the topic, and to confirm, discuss further, share on one of the platforms of Teacher Education SS, and we will get back to you. And right, otherwise, as you have asked for general queries, yes, here is a YouTube channel of mine, Dr. Yakaya Podupuganti. You can visit where you can get some information. All right, and this is my email ID. You can write down, but I don't promise answer all the questions. But I will try to address this particular topic, research related, through this platform only.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you. I'm done. Please go ahead.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you, sir. So I would like to invite Anand, sir. Anand, sir, is one of the coordinators of our teacher educators community. And right now he is a research scholar at Mahatma Gandhi Central University of Motihari, Bihar. So I would invite, sir. Welcome, sir. Over to you, sir.
Thank you. सबसे पहले मैं याकिया सर का बहुत बहुत धन्यवाद करना चाहता हूँ
सर हमेशा लेक्चर लेने के लिए हमेशा तैयार रहते हैं, कभी भी सर को इनवाइट करो तो सर मतलब तुरंत अपनी हामी भर देते हैं कि हाँ मुझे कोई दिक्कत नहीं है। मैं विद्यासागर जी, रिया जी, इंदुमती जी, आशीष जी, ढेरों लोगों का ये रिक्वेस्ट है कि इसको आगे बढ़ा दिया, तो आज तो टाइम की लिमिटेशन है लेकिन हम प्रयास करेंगे कि रविवार या सरकार को कम से कम लेकर आएंगे और क्या क्या दिया है तो प्रयास करेंगे नेक्स्ट टाइम से लेकर आएंगे। इसके साथ ही मैं बता रहा हूँ कि जैसे लोग क्वेरी कर रहे ढेर सारे लोगों की क्वेरी थी कि वो अपने प्रश्न को कैसे हमारे तक पहुंचाएं, तो उनके लिए आप टेलीग्राम ग्रुप के जो एडमिन है या वो आपकी मैसेज करते हैं, अगर आप हमारे व्हाट्सएप ग्रुप में हैं तो व्हाट्सएप ग्रुप में जो एडमिन है उनको मैसेज करेंगे, या तो आप फेसबुक ग्रुप में हैं तो फेसबुक ग्रुप पे आप मैसेज करिए कमेंट करके, किसी भी माध्यम से आप अपनी बात को पहुँचा सकते हैं। अगर हमारा नजर जाएगा वहाँ पे ई मेल आई डी तो हम वहाँ पे आप इसको लिखेंगे और रिप्लाई देंगे, या जो भी हमारे कोऑर्डिनेटर से खास लिखेगा तो जरूर आप रिप्लाई देगा। चूंकि हमारा मेन उद्देश्य ही है सभी लोगों का कि ज्यादा से ज्यादा आप लोगों को लाभ मिले इसका। अब मैं आज देख रहा था कि इतने ज्यादा लोग इंगेज हुए हैं, इतने ज्यादा लोग इंटरेस्टेड है, हमें बहुत खुशी कि इतने लोग मतलब सीखना चाहते हैं और कोई टाइम की लिमिटेशन नहीं, भागने की नहीं, बहुत अच्छा लग रहा है सब अच्छे से कि बताया कि कैसे हम करें। बिल्कुल सही बोला सर, कोई भी परफेक्ट टॉपिक नहीं होता, कोई भी परफेक्ट नहीं होता, गैप ढूंढ के जो ओरिजिनल वर्क करना चाहिए।
There was some due to this network issue, we could not get half of your words, but we got your heart. Thank you for making it. All right.
You're most
welcome. Thank you, Anand sir. आपकी आवाज कट रही थी लेकिन हम आपकी भावनाओं को समझ गए। और next I would like to invite now Sana Firdaus ma'am. She is to be research scholar. Right now she is to be research scholar and she has done MS. Sana ma'am.
topic for dissertation. So we are very grateful to you, sir, for such a wonderful lecture. Actually, I very well know the importance of topic selection. Last year, I completed my MS. So what sort of problems and confusion are faced by the students? It's very well known. So, and actually during pandemic, things are becoming challenging. Then formal one, and now you explain each and every aspect of it in a very simple way for all. Once again, thank you so much. And next, I extend my gratitude to the admin of Teacher Educators Group, Dr. Somu Sinkar, and coordinator of the lecture series, Mr. Anand Sau sir, Last but not the least, I would like to thank our beloved audience for their patience listening and active participation. Thank you. Thank you so much, all of you. Thank you.
Thank you, Sana ma'am. So now it's time to end this session. Dear participants, please stay safe and stay tuned with us at our social media platforms. Thank you. Thank you so much. Bye-bye.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you, sir. Thank you, ma'am, and everyone for creating such a good platform.